just a model of how Satan's kingdom is set up. Because they are ultimately the ones who sit at the top of all of these secret societies. I think the big secret of Masonry is once you get to the highest levels or whatever, you actually learn that there's an alien, fallen angel, that's the true god of Masonry. And it takes all those years and all those levels and all that training just for them to reveal that to you. I mean, big deal. Satan sits at the top of everything. There's no true Christian that could be involved in any of these secret societies. Because the oaths you take, first of all, are forbidden by the Bible to take oaths. Also, if you look at Masonry, even at the first stage where it says, I was in darkness and now I'm coming into light. And so these are Christians. There's over 57,000 pastors of our churches that are Masons. And they've all in these oaths, admitting that even as Christians, they were in darkness. But now because they're joining Masonry, they're going to be brought into the light of Lucifer. And so it's really blasphemous, if anybody even has a pastor associated with Masonry, that he's turned his back on God and proclaimed his loyalty to Lucifer. And you have all these people, millions of Americans, sitting in these churches run by these pastors that are Masons. I think the Southern Baptists alone have 57,000 pastors that are Masons. So how much control does Satan have over the churches today, folks? How much faith are you putting in your pastors today? We're not supposed to put our faith in man. We're not supposed to put our faith in the churches. We're supposed to put our faith in the Lord. And if you had your faith in the Lord and he was able to lead and direct you, you would have seen this famine that's coming years ago. You would have started stocking up and preparing. You would be somewhat aware of where we are in Scripture. Instead of always looking for a rapture and an escape out, you'd be spending your time preparing. And I'm going to talk a little bit about that tonight, about this whole rapture heretic crowd. They just drive me nuts. Look for an uproar the next couple of months over gas prices. Mostly food. Because what I'm seeing in the Bible codes, folks, is that there's going to be orchestrated riots over the food. Now, we've seen truckers threatening to go on strike because of the gas prices. And that's very likely. But I want to read something that I sent out this week to my list called The Coming Orchestrated Riots. Recently, the Lord has warned me of something, so I thought I would post it on this blog. And this is my blog at sherryschreiner.blogspot.com to get the word out and to warn others. This summer, the CIA is implementing uproars over food prices, in other words, food riots. These riots have been orchestrated and planned, and they will be squashed by force. Do not get involved with them. Those who actively recruit and urge others to riot and join riots will expose themselves for what they are, CIA and government pawns and agents. So it will be interesting to sit back and watch all those who get on the Let's Riot bandwagon and lead others to do so. Yahuwah told me that they will expose themselves for who and what they are. In the codes, these riots are described as ready-made and uproar. Most people expect strikes and riots over the rising gas prices. What I'm seeing is the coming riots over food. So a word to Yahuwah's people, stay away from the government-implemented, sponsored, and then crushed riots. They simply have an agenda with this. I believe it's to bring in the military and heavy-handed police who will then condition the public of their presence on our streets. Another way of bringing in the police state, martial law, and martial rule to America. As public unrest grows over food shortages, more and more police and military will make their presence known on our streets, and they won't be leaving. And they will deal harshly with simple protesters. They could implement the internment camps as temporary jails for these people. Don't be fooled by it, folks. I doubt anyone who gets placed inside a temporary jail will ever get released. Stay away from the riots. They're baiting you. And this was a word, a warning from the Lord that he gave me just the other day, and so I posted it on my blog just to warn people to stay away from these riots, because everything is ready-made. This famine that we're seeing is so unpredictable because it's being implemented by our governments themselves. You know, Bush is happier than a bug in a rug that's finally getting going. He's not crushed. He doesn't care that you're hungry, you're losing your jobs, you're losing your houses. He's happier than a bug in a rug. So don't count on the government to help you. You know, if you've been listening to the Lord, you should be listening to him now. Should be waking up now. These things are coming, and there's no rapture coming to save you from it. And so all of these pre-trib rapture people are going to be the first ones in food lines, first ones homeless, because they have not prepared. And that was the sole job of their pastors, to keep them in the dark about the truth, keep them drunk in Pauline errors and doctrines. So they wouldn't see the truth when it's coming. One of the things I found interesting, somebody sent me last week after my show, and we talked about Orgone and how it's causing UFOs to crash, and I mentioned how Reich had discovered it. Wilhelm Reich. Reich didn't, according to this info this person sent me, Reich wasn't the one who discovered that Orgone energy could cause UFOs to crash. He built off Tesla's work. It was Nikola Tesla is the one that discovered that. And of course they killed both of them and stole their work. Typical government actions. So they could keep their work hidden and use it for their own agendas. And what I think happened with Tesla, because everyone knows Tesla, you can Google the name Tesla. The government stole his patents, stole thousands and thousands of pages of his work, and ended up killing him off, just like they did Wilhelm Reich. I believe they did so because just as Tesla was the one that was the one discovering all these high-tech weapons that could be used in space, he also knew the weaknesses. He knew what could bring them down. And I think whoever stole Tesla's work was trying to keep that quiet, also trying to keep the high-tech weapons out of everyday hands so they could use this for their own agendas, and we've seen they already have. And they have a lot of weapons we haven't even seen yet from space. Russia alone could destroy every city in America from space with beam weapons. If you don't, and I saw that happening. They took down the Challenger with one. The Columbia. There's a lot of underground factions, and everything most people know is only what they see from the media. They really don't have a grasp of what's going on in the background, and so that's the problem I have with some of the code work I do. Because I often run into things that's going on in the background, not necessarily going on in the public, or going to happen in the public in the future, but going to happen in the background in the future. It's hard to tell sometimes what I'm looking at. Things that are happening in the background are things that are going to happen in the public so everybody can see it. And so that's why a lot of times I'll just go ahead and talk about it anyway, so you can become aware of it either way, whether it becomes public or it stays something that happens in the background. I found it interesting. I was working on a code the other day. And I seen this phrase, the next war, Mars Force. Sorry, next war, Mars Force. Not necessarily an alien invasion, but possibly. If Maitreya, if this cloned Kane, comes to Earth, his home base is Mars. And so, could be him coming to Earth, posing as an ascended master. He's ultimately the Antichrist. Could be him and his forces. Or we could have some kind of UFO invasion with some alien, different type of fallen angel beings, because I know a lot of people feeling that, the Lord telling people to get Orgone out, and that's the one thing it repels, that aliens don't like the Orgone. And so what I thought was really funny, because I said a couple weeks ago how I'd already seen with my own eyes that UFOs will crash when they come into the presence of an Orgone-saturated area, is that in July, and I've been telling you that there's always action for July. July 4th in America. I don't know what year it is. I don't know if it's this year or next year. But there always seems to be some kind of a dominant UFO flyover in July. And what I find interesting is that they're not even going to use alien ships for this one. They're going to be using man-made Russian ships for this one. And even Japanese UFOs. And so there's going to be a collection, probably America, Britain, China, Japan, Russia. There's going to be a collection. I've warned you guys for years that our own governments have their own fleets of UFOs. And they're going to instigate their own UFO-type flyover thing in July. And so I thought it was really funny that they're using the man-made ones because the UFO ones keep crashing. They're unreliable. So now they're going to use a Russian and Japan contingency of UFOs. That was funny. So, apparently, they want to start conditioning people that there are UFOs and an alien threat, and according to them, there is no alien threat because they're all in cahoots together. They're all in cahoots. You can go to YouTube and type in Bush and Reptilians or Bush and Aliens. I even have it at my website, thewatcherfiles.com. George Bush giving a speech, and you see gray aliens in the windows behind him. they're all in cahoots, folks. They're not enemies, and so this whole thing with July, trying to give us the illusion that we're being viciously stalked by the UFOs from space or something. I don't know what the agenda is for July. I just know that I knew I was going to have fun busting their nuts on that one tonight because they're going to be horrid and furious that I released that info because it's a big plan of theirs. And so many times, like in the past, whenever I expose their plans, they have to cancel them or delay them.